Hi YouTube, BadEditPro here. This is the fourth episode of our video series on the complete restoration of the Realistic CTR-68 tape recorder by Clydesight. If you haven't seen the other parts of the series, just click on the annotation box on your screen and jump to the first episode where we explain exactly what is going on. In this episode, we'll see Clydesight use patience and keen observation to question this machine and find its weakest link. It's surprising what he discovered. We hope you enjoy it.
The machine is back together, and first thing we're going to do is give you a sample of a Flutter Wow test tape run. It's pretty good. Now, this is a tape made by Sony WS48B. So you can hear there's a little bit of fluctuation, but not very much. That is actually pretty good. The only time I've ever heard completely absent Wow and Flutter is on digital devices. The weakest link, what is that all about? Well, once you rebuild a machine, which I have done with the transport here, you find that now that the transport is working, other problems which did not appear show up because it's like a chain. You fix the weakest link and then another link is weak. You fix that, then the next one is weak. Now, there are several weak links on this machine. First of all, of course, we know that the black wire on the erase head had popped off. Part of the reason that it happened was there is a little catch here, plastic catch, that holds the wire. And the yellow and the black wires were routed away from that. They were just floating. So that as the machine was moved forward and back and forward and back, this allowed the end of the wire to flex. Now, you know that if you flex metal for a long enough period of time, it will fatigue and break. So I have rerouted the wire into this plastic saddle, and now it does not flex. Another thing that I found was this wire here had been epoxied onto the board either by the people who made the machine or maybe somebody got into it at some point and epoxied it. Now what happened was there's a little red wire here and the only thing holding that in place was the epoxy. So I resoldered that. Another weak link I found in the actual top part of the case, which I'll show you here. The cassette door has a tab here and a tab here to prevent it opening too far. Now this tab is much smaller than this tab, and I don't know why, because they had plenty of room to make a bigger tab, but they didn't. This tab fractured, so I had to pull it off completely, get some epoxy, and glue it back down. Well, even with the epoxy, I can't trust how strong it's going to be over time. So what I did was I added a piece of red felt here to grab this when it opens so that this doesn't really hit as hard the top of the case when it pops open. So those are some of the weak links that I found in the machine. What I'm going to do now is put the machine back together and then we will do a complete test.
Clydesight has a real intuition as to what's going on inside these machines. I've worked in broadcasting for many years, and many times you'd take a tape recorder or any other piece of equipment and give it to an engineer and say, this isn't working properly, and when it came back, it would be almost there but not quite, and you'd have to send it back. Clydesight seems to intuitively know when something's not right, and he can sniff it out pretty quick, which is very cool to watch him do in this video series.
You have to be like Sherlock Holmes, a real detective, using keen observation and deductive logic to find the weakest link in these old machines. We have a little game that will help you learn to do this. Take a look at this picture. Find the objects. Press pause on the video until you find all of them.
Okay, Detective Group, how did you do? Did you find them all? Here is a picture that shows the solution. Notice that everything in the picture was there. All the objects were right there in front of you, but some of them were obvious and some of them were not. This is the way it is with your tape recorders. When you look inside the machine, you know what components to look for. You know what the logic is. But sometimes what looks right isn't. It's not just logic, it's also intuition and practice.
Well, it's obvious to me that restoring these machines takes patience and time. You can't just slap them back together. Now that the machine is restored, there's only one thing left to do. Can you guess what it is? Go to the next episode, Spit and Polish, and see the all-important final step in a tape recorder restoration.